Loon. Hi, good morning. I'm back. So I'm Roger Ruiz. I'm your master for today. Of course, I call myself master because I really wanted to share the M stands for marketer. I'm a marketer at heart. A is for an author because I do have a book also, several books that have been published. And I'm also a speaker, trainer, entrepreneur, and also a resource consultant for all the small, medium enterprise there out there. Today is a great day, great morning, magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat. And today is a very interesting topic. Definitely you'll be interested because my topic for today is our experience having a loan or taking our first ever bank loan to start the business. I'd just like to share the experiences of KJR Dental Center. We were actually established last 2006. So we have been in the business for almost 14 years in the country today. And we actually started out with just opening one branch. So we rented out a small space in Las Piñas. So this is also where my office is right now. And after several years of doing business, of course, we wanted to share the story of how can a loan in the bank can make you successful or can create a better success in your dental clinic. Of course, a lot of dentists out there, I'm sure marami po sa inyo can relate to our situation during the time that we don't have enough capital to start a business. So what we can do, so the option that we have is just to loan from the bank. So I just want to share a story about loaning your first capital in creating your practice. First, we did apply for a loan. We applied for 150,000 loan. That was 2006. And we were actually approved for 150, and we are tasked to pay for 2 years of around 6,000 or 7,000 pesos in a month. So we thought all the while that 7,000 is really quite big during the time, and how can we be able to pay that particular loan on the regular monthly basis without even trying to consider the patients coming in? But it's a mutual decision between my wife and me, and you know that I'm a risk taker, so I took that risk. I advised her to just go ahead. I will try to promote, I will try to advertise, I will try definitely to contact with the four marketing campaign that are needed in the basic, specifically during the startup. So we have the print marketing campaign, so we have the local community marketing campaign, so we also have the internal marketing campaign, and the number four is the internet marketing campaign. But during the time, we are just massively using a lot of emails, no? But that was 2006 because you know Facebook's still very young. It was just last 2004 when it was initially public offered. Okay, so what do you have to consider in owning a loan? You have to be brave, you have to be courageous, and this is one of the most important things that you should remember in and consider if you do have a loan in the bank. So first and foremost, no, try to identify how much you're going to loan and to start buying all of the materials needed. During the time, as I said, 2006, 150,000 is enough. No, that's good enough to start the dental clinic that time. But today's generation, I think today is year 2020. I think it's a good way to start probably if you do have, let's say, 300,000, 350,000 or yeah, more or less 350,000, you can start practicing. But you have to be brave, you have to be courageous. But the most important thing that you have to remember in your business as an initial, you are introducing your practice to a community right now, is forecast. Yeah, forecasting. So when you are going to forecast, you have to forecast 3 months, 6 months during the startup period. No? When you start building your practice, of course, I advise to start forecasting every year. But during the start of when you're about to start your practice, you have to forecast 3 months up to 6 months of your patients coming in, and of course also the procedures that they're going to take. So it takes a lot of research. It takes not actually a lot. It takes a little bit of research, a little bit of encouragement, and your connection and with friends. Of course, I did also a research of Dental Marketing Philippines 2 years ago, and it was written there that the number one come on in terms of patients, the number one class of patients coming into your dental practice as a startup will definitely come from your family. Okay, so it is a must for you to let all your family members, relatives, that your clinic exists. Let them know that your clinic exists. No, because this is also a common problem for a new practice. They wanted to get known. They want to be the best dental clinic in their city, the best dental clinic in their province. Excuse me. But actually, yung kapitbahay nila, hindi nga sila kilala na dentista. So this is very important. This is the basic. Number two, relatives and friends, of course, your common friends. So let them know that you do have a clinic that exists and you are now ready to provide them a better smile and a good service. Okay? So you have to forecast using all of those techniques. So how many relatives you are targeting to come this year or to come this first month, second month, how many relatives and friends that will be coming over the first month, second month. Then, if you have forecasted all of these relatives, family, and friends, that's the time you just connect with your, number two, the community. Now you start building your practice and letting the community know that you do have a dental clinic that is ready to serve the population within the community. Now, so those are the basic things that you need in building your practice. Now, if you want to start your practice and you don't have any source of money, the best way to really start is to loan from the bank. I don't recommend, I don't advise to loan from a friend, to loan from relative. So I would still recommend to loan from a bank. Why? So there are several reasons. Number one, you are forced to pay. Yes, you are forced to pay. So there will be a mission. There will be an eagerness to work hard for your practice. So it develops your personality. It also develops your mindset to really dig out and make it work in your dental practice. So it's very important in creating a habit of changing your mindset that I should build this business because primarily, I don't want to get rich yet, but primarily the first objective, because you do have an existing loan, is to pay that loan. And after you pay that loan, after 1 year or probably 2 years, just like our story, then you can now set another goal. If that goal is to expand or to bring in another chair, that is a good goal. So your vision or your mission are still the same. It will not change. You still want to be the best dentist in the city, but you take it one step at a time. You create a vision that you wanted to be the best dental clinic in the city, but the objectives should be a process in determining the goal every single month, every month or every year. Okay. So once you've established those particular vision and mission, that is now the time to expand. Expansion means adding a chair or expanding in terms of branches. All right. So there are 6 steps in the professional dental practice life cycle. Number one is idea. But when you are about to start business, it's already on the second stage. It's what we call introduction. Okay, so when you are in the process of introduction, you are not allowed to think of expansion. Okay? But your vision still exists. So you're not allowed to take up expansion. All you have to do, all your mindset must be able to pay the loan and invest in equipments, invest in training, because you are going to be ready for the third stage, which is the growth stage. In the growth stage, that's the time you entertain the thought of expansion by adding services, adding specialization, or even adding a dental chair. All right. So loan is very important. So I just like to share that with you. Our story, we were able to pay that in 2 years. And after 2 years, we were able to acquire another chair. And on the fifth year, we were able to get 3 dental chairs. And we thought, this is it. We're going to make money out of this. That's correct. Huh? We're going to make money out of this. But at the same time, we were able to service a lot of individual that needs our services. And I firmly believe on the 8th year, no, this is where the maturity comes in, we're able to expand our branches in Makati and in Paranaque. So for today, we are now concentrating on 2 branches, but 2 different segments of the market. So we'll discuss that next time. And with this, I would just like to share that loan is a very important factor in creating a business, because it teaches us the mindset to pay our obligations. It gives us the courage to do our work. It gives us the courage to really persevere and work hard to attain our vision, to attain our target. And of course, in target, you must have several objectives that goes with it that supports your target. And also at the same time, it's very important in the business that you forecast the in and out of finances in your business. With that, again, thank you very much for listening, for really trying to support the dental marketing practice in the Philippines. I would definitely love to give more information on our story and also my practice as a dental marketing practitioner. I hope you just continue to subscribe and like, and you can share this video also. At the same time, you can comment, wherein if you do have several questions, I would definitely would like to answer that, give you feedbacks on this. And I have a good news for you. So probably after a few months, we'll be going around the city, we're going around to different provinces. We're also going to interview several dentists, which are actually this will give us an opportunity to learn more from them, as I also would like to consult with them. Several clients already have been supported by yours truly, and it's amazing how they are very thankful, and I'm also very thankful. So with that, thank you very much, and I'll see you around. Bye-bye.